How do I talk about content without over spewing a lot of detail? So I've been thinking about how to shoot this video, and I figured maybe if it's more visual, or maybe if it's winged, or maybe I use a PowerPoint presentation that I would read out for you guys. And I figured it's easier for me to do this if it's something I narrate over or use what's off the top of my head, because I believe, not because I'm one of the best people out there when it comes to content or digital in Uganda, but it's because at this I've bounced off a couple of institutes that have trained me to do this. I've done some stuff with VOA, BBC, DW, Next Media right now, and of course I've been in agencies. I've experienced a couple of these things. So we're going to talk about content 101. We'll talk about video, still, text and image content. Let's go. This is part two of the series that we decided to do starting last month. Sorry I've taken so long, but I've been up and down filming and doing all these other things. It's been a crazy couple of weeks, but anyway, we're here, better late than never. So today we're talking about content, but content for online, content for social media, for web, for platforms, for widgets, you name it. So we're just going to deep dive into that. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, hit the notification bell for any upcoming videos of mine, and yeah, comments, feedback, I love it very much. It directs my content in the direction that you guys want. So yeah, let's get straight into this video. So previously we talked about social media basics in this series that we're going to do. Today we're going to talk about content. First things first, what's content? Content is images, content is pictures, content is videos, content is anything that you're going to put in place to describe or communicate something that you want to put across, be it for a brand, be it for your personal platforms, or be it for a campaign. So content is basically dictated by the ends meet. So if it's a campaign, what's the mandate for the campaign? What's the thematic? Throw that in there. If it's your personal brand, what kind of stuff are you into? Are you a movie blogger? Are you a gamer? Basically describing myself. So that content is going to be dictated by those terms. I know that those of you guys who like scientific terms. So content is basically an image, video, audio, or any other format of communication material that you're going to put out there on the internet to best describe or communicate what you want to do. So that's content 101. So we'll start with image content, which is still content. It could be a poster, it could be any frame of artwork that you're going to put on the internet, on any social media platform that would communicate. Now the things in there that you need to consider, for example, there are so many social media platforms out there. You have Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, WhatsApp. These days they roll off my tongue so easily, that are out there, but that visual content sits on these platforms in very specific ways. For instance, if you're dealing with Facebook, you're doing image content, it's going to have to be a square format. This is 513 by 513 pixels. Why is it important to do that? It's because when you're scrolling off using a mobile phone or a PC, it has to be viewed in a particular way, and the way the platform is designed. What else is important about image content on, let's say, Facebook? It has to have a certain format of text and image, which is more image and less text. Why is this? Is because of their algorithms that they're using, and also because of the fact that the customer or the end user gets to view it in a particular way. Because of so many links, because of so much interactivity and dynamism of these platforms, the limited text that you put on the platforms, the better for you, especially for reach. For those of you that have run some Facebook ads, you would know this very clearly. If your image has a lot of text, most times the ad is rejected, or sometimes it's allowed, but it's going to have very limited reach. So how does it look like? In this image, you're able to see that you have that image being over 80% on the artwork compared to the text. As long as your text is very visible, you're good to go. So apply this across all Facebook-owned platforms or even other social media platforms just for better community guidelines or use. I'll jump off Facebook and jump maybe to Twitter and say that imaging that you need to do at this point should be 513 by 315 pixels because of the format of that platform. Because it's scrolling, it needs to appear rectangular as if, or landscape for those of you that may not know that term, but it's better that you do your artwork in that format. Why is that? Because of the timeline effect. Someone doesn't need to click on your image for it to expand for them to see that this is an image. They should simply get to see, read the content up there and move. Another thing I probably should have, I forgot to say, is that why less text is important is because these platforms allow you to express your verbal or your text in the what is up, what's on your mind, or in the status field. So consider utilizing these platforms as is. Okay, so I'm going to jump away from image content. There's a lot more. I'll try and share some information. It's going to be on my website, dijan.com. That's the URL. You can go there and see a more robust or more expounded literature on, let's say, image content on Facebook, Twitter, and other platforms. Yeah, so let's jump into audio content. Audio content is a big thing right now. You can experience it through podcasts, through WhatsApp audios, through, I think Twitter is also pushing, rolling it out, the audio format of that. Facebook did that a lot. I used to see my friend Timothy Lugaisi drive to office every morning while doing some audio content or an audio update. So audio content is very important because time, people want to say a lot more, but if it's going to be in a status, it's harder to read, and also it's more therapeutic, and you get to express yourself a lot more. Like, for example, you could have just listened to this without watching it. So audio content is a big thing right now. So remember, you're going to be looking at podcasts, places like Mixcloud, SoundCloud, etc., wherever you're getting this audio content uploaded. Some dynamics about audio content: most times it's easier for it to be consumable if it's a continuous kind of content. For instance, if it's a documentary that's being broken down into various pieces, or an audiobook right now. I remember I listened to Good to Great. Kudos, Mr. King, for giving us this book. Good to Great was more consumable for me via my hearing as opposed to me reading. Not that I can't read, I can read, but I consume a lot more if I'm listening because it plays with my imagination. I close my eyes and I can envision where these people were, what they were doing, etc. I'd recommend something called Mau Mau. I have it on my computer, or if you can find it online, it's a good audio book. It's as if a docu that is reliving those moments during the Mau Mau rebellion. You get to envision because the sounding, the effects, and the feel, and everything that they put in there came out perfectly. Okay, that's some bit about audio content. Remember, I can't expound on this because this video will be freaking long. So let me jump away from audio content as well. It's applicable on WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram through visual, yeah, and other platforms that are very niched to audio content, like podcast platforms. So you need to check those out. These are a list of them that you could do, that you could do your audio and upload those things there. There's a lot more content. Remember, I'm trying to breeze over everything, even text in itself, which is called copy. If you're an advertiser or a creative or a copywriter, whenever you hear the word copy, most times people think it's the control C. No, copy means text. Text can also be in its format as content, especially the bloggers. You can see B-Wall, you can see Kojo. They're very good writers. These are the people that I'm mentioning, are the people whose content I consume in that format. I think even Dennis has seen me back in the day, but it's a very complicated relationship as to how I know this gentleman's content. But yeah, text content is good, especially for the writers, for you that love to read books. Same thing, it will capture your imagination. It allows you to express yourself verbally as well. So that's text content. And then lastly, the one I would like to talk about would be the video content.